I always thought my story like this. Jan van Riebeeck came, you know, with these people, and he planted the hedge. But the hedge was to protect his cattle, Jan van Riebeeck's cattle, you know, from the Khoisan people's cattle, you know, that were here. But my real question is, where did Jan van Riebeeck get his cattle from? That to me is a mystery, because nobody has ever answered my question on where Jan van Riebeeck got his cattle from.
While I'm forming the kind of mechanical barrier, and the bramble was forming like the defensive barrier in terms of the thorns and the kind of, or should I say, the attacking barrier.
And of course, 1968, when we were removed, I don't like that word, when we were kicked out. Oh, that sounds a better one, eh?
April anno 1660, vijf en de zes dito. Betogen lucht en de wind als boven. In het fort werden opnieuw vrede gemaakt en de beloofd aan weerkanten den anderen niet meer te molesteren.
So as these branches rot and break, they collapse, and then these surrounding branches then collapse with them.
You must just decide what you are going to do with the history that is there already. And I mean, why won't you tell, you know, of a tree that is 355 years old? I mean, it's older than South Africa. 355. You tell me that. I tell the story. It's an historical event. Nobody can take that away.